Ah, well, well.
Here we are again. People of Earth, how are you? Good evening and welcome to episode 142 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey, with me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence. Here to bring you the usual mix of cover tunes that I have no business doing, and an original song of mine that I hope you'll like. My favorite band first. Katie tried, I was halfway crucified, I was on the other side of no tomorrow. You walked in and my life began again, just when I spent the last piaster I could borrow. All night long we would sing that stupid song. Sang, I knew was true. Are you with me, Doctor? Are you really just a shadow of a man that I once knew? Are you crazy? Are you blind? But just an ordinary guy. Have you done all you can do? Are you with me, Doctor? Seem right. I've been strung out here all night. I've been waiting for the taste you said you'd bring to me. Biscayne Bay, where the Cuban gentlemen sleep all day. I went searching for the song you used to say to me. That is from 1975's Katie Lied. My favorite Steely Dan album. Their least favorite. Apparently they tried some new digital recording technology and knocked them out the way they liked it. But hey, I don't care. I like it. Let me check my recording device. Alrighty. Hey. Greetings from our nation's capital or thereabouts. Thanks for joining us. All right. So, usually I'll come on and do this show, and more often than not, someone from the world of rock and roll has died in the interim between the last show and the current show. Yeah, I remember hearing that the last of the Spinners died, and yeah, I did want to pay tribute to that, but, you know, those of you who know me on the Facebook and follow me
will know that my brother Dick died on February 7th, and I wanted to think about him a little bit because my musical influences came from all sorts of places, from my mother's stack of sheet music of the 30s to my daughter's scene and pop punk bands in the early decade of this century, to the stuff my brother Dick listened to when he was in college and high school and I was 10-ish or so. But one of the genres of music that he was very much interested in was protest music, which was happening in the early 60s. A guy named Phil Oakes was one of his favorites, and eventually one of my favorites. And he wrote protest songs. He had a political conscience and a social conscience. I'll do a couple snippets of some of his most favorite songs, his most popular songs. March to the Battle of New Orleans. At the end of the early British Wars, the young land started growing, the young blood started flowing, but I ain't marching anymore. For I've killed my share of Indians in a thousand different fights. I was there at the Little Big Horn. So many more dying, but I ain't marching anymore. It's always the old who lead us into war. It's always the young to fall. Now look at all we've won, oh, with the saber and the gun. Tell me, is it worth it all? I stole California from the Mexican. Fought in the bloody Civil War. Yes, I even killed my brothers and so many others, but I ain't marching anymore. Three or four verses more to that song, but I ain't marching anymore. A classic protest anti-war song from the early 60s from Phil Oakes, the 1965 album of that same name, I Ain't Marching Anymore. One of his socially conscious songs was inspired by a woman named Kitty Genovese, who in 1964 was attacked, stabbed, murdered in Brooklyn, New York, I think it was, in the full view of a whole bunch of people in an apartment building, and they watched the whole thing go down, and nobody did anything about it. Phil wrote this tongue-in-cheek song, tragic. Look outside the window, there's a woman being grabbed. They dragged her to the bushes, now she's being stabbed. Maybe we should call the cops and try to stop the pain. But Monopoly is so much fun, I'd hate to blow the game. And I'm sure it wouldn't interest anybody outside of a small circle of friends. Sweating in the ghetto with the panthers and the poor. Rats have joined the babies who are sleeping on the floor. Now wouldn't it be a riot if they really blew their tops? But they got too much already, and besides we got the cops. And I'm sure it wouldn't interest anybody outside of a small circle of friends. Smoking marijuana is more fun than drinking beer. But a friend of ours was captured and they gave him 30 years. Maybe we should raise our voices, ask somebody why.
demonstrations are a drag, and besides, I'm much too high, and I'm sure it wouldn't interest anybody outside of a small circle of friends, and so on. From Phil Oakes. Who committed suicide at age 36 in 1976. This is one of the types of music that my brother Vic got me into. I'll visit a couple more genres here, but let's talk about this day in history and what national day it is. It is National Tortilla Chip Day. It is National Trading Card Day. Well, those are two things you don't want to confuse, or you'll be chewing a lot. It is also World Bartender Day, which, sure, if you're going to celebrate bartenders, celebrate them worldwide for sure. Hey, if you had your TV time machine, you go back to 1964, and on this evening, the Beatles did their third performance on the Ed Sullivan Show. This one was taped, actually. What else is going on in history? 2022, 2 years ago, marks the beginning of the invasion of Ukraine by Russia. And we have birthdays and death days today. 1947. Two guys are 77 years old, the actor Edward James Olmos and the singer-songwriter Rupert Holmes of Pina Colada fame. His real name is David Goldstein, which I found out today for the very first time. I thought Rupert Holmes was his real name. Yeah. On this day in 1921, Abe Vigoda was born. And he is now actually dead. He died in 2016. In 1950, George Thorogood was born. He's 74. In 1918, Catherine Goebel Johnson, one of the subjects of a great movie with Taraji P. Henson and Kevin Costner and Hidden Figures, about the Mercury mission and the group of genius black women who worked on the calculations for those Mercury flights. But Catherine Goebel, she was born in 1918. She died in 2020 at the age of 101. Born just a year before her in 1917 was Chief Trainer Ora Heftown, Native American TV host of TV shows in Philadelphia, maybe elsewhere, I'm not sure. He died in 2003 at the age of 86. And geez, that's all the dates that are fit to commemorate. Tomorrow, the 25th of February, the Yankees play the Phillies in their opening spring training game in Clearwater. So Philadelphia fans now have something to look forward to again. And geez, it's going to be months and months and months before our hopes are dashed once more. But go Phils, Yankees and Phillies tomorrow afternoon from Clearwater. Start of spring training. Anyway, back to my brother, who had a bunch of favorite genres that he passed along to me. One of them, I admit to this day, is probably my favorite kind of music. That is samba or bossa nova. And in 1964, this song won a Grammy for Record of the Year. And it hit number 5 in the Stan Getz Astrid Gilberto version. Garota. face so gently that when she passes, each one she passes goes.
Originally were done in Portuguese, because Brazil. Antonio Carlos Jobim wrote the song. I'm not sure who wrote the Portuguese lyrics, but the English lyrics were written by Norman Gimbel, whom you will know from all sorts of TV theme song lyrics, like Happy Days and Laverne and Shirley and Angie. And he also maybe wrote the lyrics to Killing Me Softly. Anyways, let's continue with a song my brother taught me. In 1968, from their second album, the jazz rock band. Blood, Sweat, and Tears.
Sometimes laughter from your tears to ease my pain.
By Steve Katz. Bloodsweat and Tears. And you know, that's it. Just a couple of things that remind me of Richard Case Metz MD. And I said before, Godspeed, bro. This next tune is from probably my favorite David Bowie album, Hunky Dory. This did not chart in the US. It was from 1971, but it was hit number 12 in the UK charts. And in opposition to all the other songs on this album, for which Rick Wakeman played the piano, David Bowie himself played the piano on this song. So let's see if I can match what he did. I doubt it. Your children, see their faces in golden rays. Don't kid yourself, they belong to you. They're the start of a coming race. The earth is a bitch, we finish our news. Homo sapiens have outgrown their use. All the strangers came today, and it looks as though they're here to stay. Driving the mamas and David Bowie, 1971. Oh, you pretty things. All right. Let me see if I can get this. That's what I want, and I want this. I want these, and I want to do this. And must have had doctors on my mind when I thought about this song, because this has some medical advice in it. It's from their 1973, they're the fifth album from this band. Another one of my favorite bands. It's Caravan, the dog, he's at it again.
Oh, lonely girl, would you like a sweet to eat? I've got something that I'd like you to hold. My brother will tell you that it's good for your gold. Oh, yeah, surely there's nothing wrong. Take my hand and we'll try to make a stand for all censorship, decency, all night long. You're naive if you really do believe that the world is so full of sin. Never look back on the things that you lack when you're in. My mother said that I should stay out of bed, but I know that I like it in there. Legs and thighs and loves and goodbyes, it's all there.
So let's move along, and let's not forget my other brother Darryl. Number 33 hit. Mary wants to be a superwoman.
just wanna live each day and love her for what she is. Mary wants to be another movie star, but is that really in her mind? All the things she wants to be, she needs to leave behind. Summer came, you were not around. Now the summer's gone and love cannot be found. But where were you when I needed you last winter, my love? When the winter came, you went further south, parting from love's nest, leaving me in doubt. Where are you when I need you right now? Love is an ally, yet you say you've changed, but tomorrow will reflect love's past. When the winter came, love could not be found. Where were you when I needed you last winter, my love? Tomorrow will reflect love's past. Spring will fill the air, you will come around. Well, is it summer love that will let me down? Where were you when I needed you last winter, my love?
Yeah, that's most of that. All the covers that I had no business doing. let's take a look now at an original song that I had no business doing. Fortunately, this is a short one, just a don't know how to write a song. I really don't. Anyway, brings us to the conclusion of episode 142 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Which, within the next half hour or so, will be up on the website for people who don't have Facebook. That is to say, people under 30. I don't know. But it's going to be on my site, housearrestconcert.com. So you can come check that out. I'll put it up there. Toot the sweet. And I'll see you next time. Thanks everybody for watching.